What is up, my sociology peeps? Today, we will be taking a sociological deep dive into the movie Star Wars: The Force Awakens. So without any further ado, let's just get straight into the analysis. The first question I must answer is, why did I choose this movie?
I like Star Wars.
Next, we have, what is the meaning of the movie's title? Well, the title Force Awakens is referring to the main character Rey, as she is the newest Jedi and user of the Force in the Star Wars universe. This title also refers to our other new characters to show the new rebels that are fighting the forces of evil within this universe. So, what did I learn? Well, I learned that this movie is just jam-packed with sociology, but we'll get to that later. I also learned that gaslighting is apparently very easy to do. For example, Kylo Ren literally gaslit his dad into thinking he had changed and then just proceeds to kill him. The fact that anyone trusted him after he caused the destruction of multiple planets is actually insane. As for what impressed me, the visuals in this movie are actually insane. And you have to think, a majority of this movie was probably filmed in front of a green screen, so the fact that they were able to make the film look so realistic is incredible. Also, the fan service was just so good, the callbacks and the returning characters were really nice to see. Now, this movie had a ton of sociology topics. There was learning and socialization, there was a lot of social control, conformity, and resistance. There was some social identity and change, and there was some diversity. A really well-rounded sociology movie, if you ask me. But now let's get into some more specific examples. Going in no particular order, the first example will be of non-conformity. Within the First Order, stormtroopers are meant to have one objective: do as they're told and shoot anyone who gets in their way. However, one stormtrooper doesn't want to conform like the others. Finn was a stormtrooper that wasn't happy with the way the First Order did things, thus he did his own thing. If there was an ambush, he wouldn't kill anyone. He also helped one of the rebels, Poe, escape from the First Order and left with him, thus leaving his life as a stormtrooper behind. Within the movie, the term nonconformity even came up. Another example we get is of assertive femininity. Rey is a girl that absolutely kicks butt. She does things on her own and is very strong, and sometimes when offered help, it denies it, such as when Finn kept grabbing her hand and she said, "Stop taking my hand." She also said, "I can handle myself," when Han Solo offered her a job. However, she still does possess some classic feminine traits, like being emotional and crying. Another example we see is of a single-person household. We see that Rey lives all by herself in an old AT-AT walker, with no children, siblings, a partner, or family in general. Another example we see is the idea of socialization. We learn in the movie from Finn that all stormtroopers are taken from their families when they are young and are socialized into the First Order way of thinking. This could act as their primary or secondary socialization, depending on how young the children are. We also get a direct quote from General Hux, in which he states,
"My men are exceptionally trained, programmed from birth."
Another example we get to see is of subordinate masculinity. Finn may have once been a stormtrooper, but he is nothing like them. Yes, at times he showed bravery, but for most of the movie, he was very much a coward. For example, he was trying to take care of Chewbacca, who had been injured, and he said something along the lines of, "Oh, he's trying to kill me," in which Chewie proceeded to grab him by the neck and Finn was all like, "Which is perfectly fine," and just immediately backed down. Another example we see is of power. The Force is very strong in the Star Wars universe and can be used for good or bad, and in this case, it was used for bad. Kylo Ren used the power of the Force to make Poe give him the location of the map to Skywalker against his will. Poe didn't want to tell Kylo Ren, but if he hadn't, he probably would have died. Another example we see is resistance. In this case, the resistance we see is quite literally the group called the Resistance that fights the First Order in an attempt to restore peace to the galaxy. Their behavior is viewed as deviant by the First Order, and the First Order does whatever it takes to stomp out the rebellion. And the final example I will be talking about is dramaturgy theory, and I probably pronounced that wrong. In this case, Finn plays the role of hero. When Ray first met Finn, she assumed he was resistance because Finn was wearing Poe's jacket. And rather than tell the truth, Finn painted this image that he was some hotshot for the resistance. Later on, Ray finds out the truth, and Finn reveals that he kept up the act because he said no one had ever looked at him the way that Ray did. She saw him as brave and as a hero, and he wanted to live out that illusion for a little bit longer. All in all, Star Wars The Force Awakens is a movie that is just jam-packed with sociology and is a really good film overall. Many things can be learned from this movie and other movies within the Star Wars franchise. And with that said, this is the end of my analysis of Star Wars The Force Awakens. I'll see you guys around, and may the Force be with you.